Hello guys, Neapel Times, and welcome to a new video. And today I'm gonna show you how to use WhatsApp on your Apple Watch. Okay, so as you know, WhatsApp is this messaging app by Facebook or Meta or whatever. I don't know if you've heard of it. But yeah, it's for some reason it's the most popular messaging app in so many countries, including Spain. For some reason, because it's also one of the worst messaging apps, but whatever. Yeah, they're lacking so many features compared to the competition, and the one that brings us here today is the lack of an Apple Watch app. So, for example, apps like Telegram have a very good Apple Watch app that you can use to reply messages if you're out of your phone or whatever, but WhatsApp doesn't. But thankfully, there's a developer that has made a third-party app to use WhatsApp on your Apple Watch. Now, this is especially helpful if you have the cellular Apple Watch and are often away from your phone. This way you can use WhatsApp on your Apple Watch and don't be out of the loop. But yeah, without further ado, I'll go and explain step by step how you can get this app and then explain the main functionalities of it. Okay, so of course the first thing you need to do is go to the App Store and download the app, and it's called Watch Chat 2. I will put a link down below in the description to the iTunes Store so you can download it. But yeah, now once it has downloaded on your iPhone, it will of course download on your Apple Watch as well. So you want to tap on the app on the Apple Watch, and after a few seconds it will show you a QR code. Then you should take your iPhone and scan that QR code. Now here comes a little trick. I had some trouble scanning the QR code myself, and I'm pretty sure it was either because it was too small or the Apple Watch was too bright. So what I did was the following. I took the iPad and took a photo of the Apple Watch, like this, with the QR code, and then went ahead and scanned the photo, zoomed in and scanned the photo from the iPhone directly, and then I could connect. But yeah, once WhatsApp recognizes the code, it will scan it directly and you're in. Okay, so then this is what you will see on your Apple Watch. As you can see, it looks really similar to WhatsApp. Like, these are my most recent conversations and everything. They're in Spanish, sorry about that, but yeah, it is what it is. My friends are Spanish, especially the ones I use WhatsApp with, so they're in Spanish. But yeah, it looks very similar. However, it will not save if you have any pinned chats at the top. This will just appear in chronological order. But then, once you tap into a chat, you will of course see the latest messages, which is great, and you can reply. So if you click on the keyboard, you will see this. Now, I hadn't seen a keyboard like this in so many years, and if you're very young and you're watching this, you probably haven't seen a keyboard like this ever. So this keyboard used to be in phones before they had touchscreens. And the way they work is, you see like there's several letters on each key. So if you want to get the L here, which is the third letter, you have to tap three times. So you see, then the bar appears again and you can put another one, like the E. And then if I want the T, and you get the point. Now, I found that it is possible if you go to settings to change the layout of the keyboard. However, you probably don't want to do that because this is supposed to be a QWERTY keyboard. And as you see, it's split in three rows, so it's even more confusing. But yeah, this is pretty annoying, not gonna lie. I mean, I think it's a very good idea and a very good solution for the Apple Watch. With this small screen, but I just really didn't expect it. Like, when I saw it, I was like, wow, this is so old. But then if you tap reply, you will have all the usual functions that you usually have on the Apple Watch. So if you tap here, you have scribble. Of course, that wasn't a letter, but yeah, you can put emoji, dictate the text, etc, etc. And here you can record voice messages and send them directly through the watch, which is probably the way you want to go if you're on the watch. You want to send a voice message and send it, and that's it. So this is very good, actually. Now, I don't usually use WhatsApp, but this is very helpful. Then at the bottom, you have some contacts and some settings. And yeah, if you go to contacts, you can see your contacts and I guess start new messages. And here you have some settings that you can move around yourself if you want. But yeah, this is WhatsApp for the Apple Watch, the best way to use WhatsApp on your Apple Watch. Okay, so to say one bad thing, when you get a WhatsApp notification on the Apple Watch, it will not go directly to the Watch app. So if you see the notification, you have to close it and go yourself to Watch app and then reply from there. That's the one con I see on the app, but it will probably keep updating and maybe it's on one day it will work with the notifications. But yeah, sadly, there is one other con, and is that, of course, this great thing is not free. Now, you can download it for free and try it free for 3 days. However, after that, you will have to pay for it. But before you click out of this video, it's very cheap. Very, very cheap. It is just 4.49 euro per year. Now, I don't know the exact price in dollars or in other currencies. It will be about $4 or $5, I'm guessing, per year. Not per month, per year. So, yeah, that's what, like, 30 cents per month, like 1 cent per day, pretty much. So yeah, that's like super super cheap. And yeah, if you ever thought like, oh man, I wish I could just reply to messages on my WhatsApp, like on my watch, then you're probably already like would have mind it. Like it's probably worth for you. For me personally, I don't know if I will get it, 'cause like I don't really use WhatsApp. I don't really like WhatsApp. But yeah, like if you have a cellular Apple Watch and if you ever thought like, oh man, I wish I could reply to messages on my Apple Watch, then it's for you, 100%. Don't think it, just buy it, because it's like $5 or even less per year. It's like so little. So yeah, just go ahead. But yeah, that said, I will let you decide if this app is for you. But in the meantime, if you decide that this video was helpful, I would be very thankful if you drop a like down below. Also, if you have any questions at all about this, please let me know down below in the comments. And also, you will see, like, especially in the setup process, if you have any issues with the app, you directly get the email that you can write to ask about your questions. So, yeah. But still, if I can help with anything, I'll try my best. And you can leave it in the comments down below. And also, if you like Apple and want to get the most out of your Apple devices, you should subscribe because I upload new videos twice per week. Also, please let me know what you think of this video because I'm trying out a new camera and I have the microphone and everything. So, yeah, it's probably not the perfect video, but I'll get there 100%. So, yeah, just let me know how it is, how's the quality and everything, and I will try to improve for the future. But, yeah, that's gonna be everything for today. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.